This is part two of our How to Use Honeybook course, which is this whole playlist. So check it all out if you're new here. And again, if you're ready to invest in Honeybook, use my link and my discount code to get up to 50% off. So in this video, I'm going to cover projects and contacts in Honeybook. Projects comes first. I think you'll use it more, but I'm going to start with contacts. These are the building blocks of basically everything that you do in Honeybook, and a lot of people call Honeybook a CRM, which is a client relationship manager, or a CMS, which is client management. So think about contacts as clients, people who have booked, as well as people who have not booked. And then you also can form contacts with other businesses. So for instance, a Toast to Beauty was a makeup artist that I've worked with on several occasions. So you can form contacts with people who haven't officially booked with you, but do other things with you. I was going to also use them for my wedding. So you'll see some things on here that were actually me as the client, and it's all kind of in the same database, which is really nice. Clients will be anyone who's booked a project with you, and then leads will be anyone who's sent in a lead form or been entered in here as a lead but hasn't booked a project. And then as you see, all contacts, I have 43, so that can contain a few more people like other businesses. You can add a contact manually, and it can either be an organization or a client/lead. Go up here and you just have to require the full name and the email address of this client. You can fill in a few other things if you like to, and then you can also add in their mailing address and any private notes only visible to you. I like that they specify that. And then if you do work with a lot of people within the same organization for your work, you can add the organization. The organization will also be its own contact, and then all of the clients will be associated with that organization. If you go to add an organization, it's very simple here. There's not a whole lot you're required to do, and then you can also add a new client within that organization in the same tab. I'm going to go ahead and add a contact. Let's do Amy Santiago 99, and we'll see Amy at 99.com. And that's really all we need here to add her into our system. When you go into a client, you can see that you can add them to a project really easily. You can see all the communication and payments. You can also see their worth, which I love. Something that Honeybook has a lot of is little helpful tools to show you where your money is going and coming from, any meetings with them, and then any notes that you have on them. And then lastly, something that Honeybook has that a lot of other client management systems don't is the ability to upload additional clients, like multiples at a time. So a lot of these tools only allow you to add one client manually at a time. I'll show you an example of a way that they can take some of this work off your plate, but if you already have a bunch of contacts that you want to go ahead and add in here, you can import from Google Contacts or upload a spreadsheet of them. And then at any point, if you're doing something outside of the system and you need to download all of your contacts, you can do that as well. Now that we have our contact that we want in here, how would we start a project? We can go into Amy's name and then we can add her to a project, but there are a couple other ways you can do this as well. I'll click on this projects tab to show you what this looks like. So your pipeline is what you see at the top, and this is basically the whole process flow of where everyone goes from lead all the way through a completed and archived project. And you can customize the pipeline by clicking up here. There are a few of these stages that you might not be able to delete or remove, but you can rename these stages. So like I can change meeting to consult. You can trash some of these stages, and you can add stages as needed. So you might find that you prefer different names. So now that meeting has changed to consult. And as an invitation designer, for instance, I might want some like after the retainer's paid, I might wanna have the ones that are in the sketching phase, the designing phase, the production phase, et cetera, so that I can click on them and see all of the different projects at a higher level. Now, I think that projects are fairly self-explanatory. It's basically one project that you're working on with your clients. Any client can have multiple projects. As an invitation designer, I might have a different project for save the dates, invitations, and then wedding day stationery. Also, you can have multiple clients on a project, so you might be working on different things with different people from the same organization a few different times. You might want to add a wedding planner as a contact, etc. So when you go into my project, for instance, you're going to see me, Laney, that's also me. And then you can add an additional client, collaborator, or one of my own team members to this project as well. We saw one way to add a project through the contact tool. However, what if you want to just skip immediately to the project and don't want to add the contact separately? You can just click up here and click new project, and we'll just say Amy and Jake wedding invitations. Change to wedding invites. Let's say they found me on Google and their wedding is going to be March 9th. We'll create our project here. And then right now it's only visible to me, as you can see here. So in order to do this automatically pulls up for us to add a client. And if we wanted to use an existing client, we could. So let's go ahead and just add Jake in here as a new client, so jake@99.com, just to show how easy that is. And then we could again add the addresses and the notes, add that here, so we can again add Jake. And then if we wanted to, we can also add Amy on here, so we have both of them on this project. When we open this project, we'll be able to see everything about it. So we can schedule things, we can upload things, create a file, see all of the past activity, all past files, payments, and then details. If you remember, when we were over here in our company settings, there was an option for details and we added venue name. So that's right here. We can just put this as the 99 precinct. That's where they actually got married. Although they didn't plan it. So we can go ahead and put that in here for them. And then there's a lot of stuff that's only visible to you. Again, I love that they denote which things are private and which things are not. So we can go into the time tracker, tasks, notes. We can set up an automation and do a bunch of other things here. From this project page, it's really easy to just send them an email by just clicking on that send to Jake and Amy. It's automatically going to send to both of them. In addition to seeing everything that has happened, you can pretty much do anything directly from this project page as well. So sending that email, if we go into payments, it's really easy to create an invoice. If we go into files, it's really easy to create a new one. And again, you can schedule and upload things from up here as well. So your project is basically your home base for everything that's going on with this client or any actions you want to take with this client. In general, you can also do a lot of those things from up here. So you could create a file or an invoice and then choose which project or client you want to apply it to up there. So in general, I'm looking at the projects page a lot because I'm seeing how many I have, where they are in the pipeline, what's going on, going into each project to send things, etc. But contacts are also going to be really important to understand because they're kind of the building block of everything. So without the contacts, we can't really have the project. But in a lot of cases, you'll just create the project and then it'll prompt you to create that contact right away in conjunction with the project. So you don't even really have to spend much time on this contacts tab. But what if you actually wanted to make the client create the project and the contact instead of you having to do that? You can actually make it so that the client has to fill out all this information and you don't have to create these things manually each time. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to set up a contact form.